this 12-year-old in the oversized inmate uniform is not a boy in the eyes of State Attorney Angela Corey. She declared that Christian Fernandez should be tried as an adult on a first-degree murder charge, which carries the mandatory penalty upon conviction of life in prison without parole. He sits with adult inmates in court, is addressed as an adult by the judge.
Mr. Fernandez, you have discussed with your attorneys your right to a speedy trial.
And for the first few weeks of his imprisonment, he sat in this adult jail in solitary confinement, the youngest person in Florida to be charged as an adult for murder. A judge did ultimately rule he could be held in a juvenile facility while still being tried as an adult. This is what Angela Corey said last year when he was arrested.
And it will be a very dramatic, to say the least, sight to see a 12-year-old who looks like a 12-year-old up here in adult court. But we want the public to understand at this point we have no choice.
No choice? Many people vehemently disagree, such as the man who had the state attorney job before her and decided not to run for re-election. Harry Shorstein was Angela Corey's boss.
No, I clearly think the decision was a travesty.
And then there's this man, the former president of the American Bar Association, the former president of Florida State University, and a current professor in the university's law school.
This is off the charts in terms of overcharging, in my judgment.
Christian Fernandez is accused of killing his 2-year-old brother David by pushing him twice into a bookshelf. He also broke his leg one time before. But all acknowledge that Christian had been abused for much of his life, particularly by his stepfather, who ended up committing suicide when he found out he was going to be arrested for that abuse. And then there's a story of Christian's mother. She gave birth to Christian when she too was 12 years old. She was away when Christian assaulted his brother. But when she came home and saw her 2-year-old was seriously hurt, she waited 8 hours before getting medical attention. For doing that, she too is implicated in this case. She pleaded guilty to aggravated manslaughter. But her 12-year-old son got the far more serious charge. Listen to what Angela Corey said last year about why she charged the 12-year-old, who had no previous arrest record, as an adult.
At what point do you step in and just come down hard so that you prevent a future murder? And that's how we felt in this case. If we don't intervene now and do the right thing and do the tough thing, whether people think, you know, it's the just thing to do because of his age, we have to protect the public from this young man.
Preventing a future murder. Angela Corey would not talk to us on camera, but her prosecutor, who will try the case in court, would. So I asked him about that comment.
Was that an unfortunate choice of words?
I don't necessarily believe it was an unfortunate choice of words. I believe our consideration...
But does she have a crystal ball? How would you know you're preventing a future murder?
And unfortunately, some of the background and information in this case we cannot discuss.
And what about Angela Corey saying she is doing the tough thing?
Our role as constitutional officers is not to be tough. Is to do what's right.
I know, but you said here, we need to intervene now and do the right thing and the tough thing. Whether people think it's the just thing to do because of his age, we have to protect the public. She's saying the opposite.
No,
are you saying I'm misinterpreting it?
I think you're misinterpreting it. The tough thing that she's saying right there is the difficult decision that she had to make.
Angela Corey says she'd like to reach a plea bargain so Christian Fernandez doesn't spend his entire life in prison. But if there is no plea bargain, that could indeed happen.
I think she wants to be our equivalent to the sheriff in Phoenix who keeps people in tents.
I don't know of a single 12-year-old that's capable of forming the kind of intent that would be necessary to sustain a first-degree murder conviction.
Christian Fernandez's defense attorneys are working for free and, not wanting to anger the prosecution team, have decided not to comment for the story.
When you sleep at night, are you comfortable with this decision?
Absolutely. I can go home, I can look my family, my 12-year-old, in the face and feel comfortable that what we are doing in the prosecution of Christian Fernandez is the right thing.